Welcome guys, I am Parinita. Subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to receive regular notifications regarding the computer science topics and technical job updates. Hello guys, welcome to my channel to polish your CSE concepts with me. So let's get started. In today's video, we are going to see very interesting topic and actually a very important topic of data mining and data warehouse, that is OLAP operations. In my previous video, we have already seen in detail that what do we mean by OLAP, what is OLTP. Fine, we have seen the basic differences between them and what they actually do. We have seen those things in detail. Now in today's video here, we are going to see what these OLAP operations are all about, why they are needed. We will see these 5 OLAP operations in detail with the help of complete figures and examples. Fine, so let's get started. First of all, the question is, what are OLAP operations? So we can say that they are based on, let's see the basic definition that you can write if asked in the exam, and then we will try to understand it. So OLAP operations are nothing but they are based on multi-dimensional data model and allows the user to query on multi-dimensional data. OLAP cube is a data structure that is optimized for proper data analysis. Fine. So what did you understand by this? What are OLAP operations? We know that OLAP stands for Online Analytical Processing. That means what? We are taking a huge amount of historical data or existing data. What we are doing is we are analyzing that data, we are observing that data, and based on the analysis, we are providing result to the queries. So whenever we want to, so OLAP is all about that, fine, to process the query and to provide result based on our analysis. So why these OLAP operations are needed? Whenever we are having multi-dimensional data like this, for example, here you can see we are having one cube. This is actually known as OLAP cube. Here we are having 3-dimensional data, location, time, and items. Fine. And so whenever we are having multi-dimensional data, that is 2D, 3D, 4D data, and we want to fire any query on this and we want to get any specific type of data from this, so what we can do, we can perform OLAP operations on this data cube to abstract that particular data that we want. Fine. So that is the main task of the OLAP operation. So these are the 5 main OLAP operations that we will see one by one, that how that can be applied on the OLAP cube to extract any details or to extract any data. Fine. Okay. So the 5 basic analytical operations that can be performed on OLAP cube, that means the 5 main OLAP operations are drill down, roll up, dice, slice, and pivot. So let's see one by one. Now, for example, this is the main data given to you. What this data is, we are having three dimensional data. The 3 dimensions are location, time, and item types. These are the 3 dimensions and their data is given to us. 3 dimensional data means nothing but we will be having 3 axes. In x axis we are having item types, in y axis we are having time, that is given in quarters q1, q2, q3, q4, and in z axis we are having location in terms of cities. Now this q1, q2, q3, q4 means what? Quarters are given, in terms of quarters, 4 quarters are given. That means we know that we are having 12 months in a year, so if 4 quarters are given, that means each quarter contains 3 months. Fine. So instead of giving in year or in month, they have given the time in quarters. So basically this is the main data given to you, and what we will do is we will apply the operations one by one to abstract any specific data. Now let's see the example. First one is drill down. Now what do we mean by drill down operation? What happens in drill down? As the name itself indicates, we want to drill down into any specific information. That means what? If any information is given to us, but we want the data or the information in more detail. Fine. There are 3 dimensions. If in case of any dimension we want its detailed information, what we will do? We will simply drill down. We will try to get detailed information or more information, digging that down. Fine. So this is about drill down. For example, let's see the example. If you are told that find out apply, if you are told to apply drill down on time. Drill down on time means time is one of the dimensions. The 3 dimensions are location, time, and item types. What we want here, we want to drill down or to get detailed information in case of this time. So whenever this type of question is asked, that drill down on time, so what we can do is we have to drill down on this particular dimension time. That means the dimensions, that is location and item types, will be as it is. We are not going to change them. So the location, in the location cities, these four cities were there, so they will be as it is. These four item types will be there. There were four item types, so they are as it is. Now what we want to do is we want to drill down on time. Now previously the time was given to us in terms of quarters, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Fine. But now we want to get more detail. So as I told, in one quarter, basically we are having 3 months. So in this, what we will do is, instead of writing them in four quarters, we will divide them into complete 12 months. Fine. So what we have done here, only four rows were there for Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Here we have made 12 rows with all the months, with having the information of all the months. Here we were getting only the information of four quarters, but here we will get specific information of all the month individually. Fine. So we can say that by this figure, we can say that what we have done here, we have simply drilled down on time. That means these two dimensions are as it is, and we have drilled down or gone into detail into this dimension time. Fine, got it? Okay. Now, what is our second operation? Our second operation is roll up. So you can remember it like, roll up is nothing but it is kind of exactly opposite to drill down. In drill down, what we used to do, whatever information is there, if we want more detailed information, we used to drill down. So just the opposite happens in roll up. Roll up means what? Whatever detail is given to us, if we want one level above information, that means we don't want that much detailed information, we want overall information, some generalized information, then we can use roll up. It is simply opposite to drill down. So let's see with the help of example. If we are applying roll up on location, then what will happen? Earlier, in the given cube, we were having in location, the information were given in terms of cities. We were having four cities: Chicago, New York, Delhi and Mumbai. We know that Chicago and New York are of USA and Delhi and Mumbai are of India. Fine. So what they are telling now is, we want to roll up on this location. Rolling up means we don't want these detailed information, we want just generalized information. So what we can do is, instead of dividing into four parts or each of one city, what we can do, we can simply roll it up, and we can just provide two information. Instead of four informations, we can just provide two informations in terms of country. So instead of Chicago and New York individually, we can provide it as one information of USA, and instead of Delhi and Mumbai two information, we can simply give it in one information of USA, of India. So what we have done, instead of dividing or instead of giving the information of particular cities, we have just merged the cities into countries, and now we have rolled it up and we will just provide the information in terms of country. So again, here also we want to roll up on location. So quarters and the items, these will remain as it is. We just have to roll up on this location. So instead of now four rows and four columns, we are just having columns are as it is, we are just having two rows. Fine. Earlier we were having 16 cells, now we will have only 8 cells. Fine. So roll up is just opposite to drill down. In drill down, our number of columns and rows were increasing, but in case of roll up, we want generalized information, so our number of rows and columns will decrease. Fine. So this is all about roll up. Now our third operation is dice. Now what do we mean by dice? You must be knowing that in games we are using dice. In Ludo we have dice. Fine. So when dice is used, whenever we want any small part, see, this is the whole cube given to us. Now whenever we want any small part of the cube, any small information in the form of any small part of cube, then we can extract it with the help of this dice. How? For example, if any query given to you that we want only the information regarding Delhi and Mumbai, regarding the quarters of quarter 1 and quarter 2, and only regarding the items Mumbai and modem, only regarding the items mobile and modem. Fine. If any such query is there, so you can only pick up this much part of cube that will become like this, and it is known as dice operation. So we are only showing the details of Delhi and Mumbai, Q1 and Q2 quarters, and mobile and modem, these two items. Fine. So this is what dice is. Simply remember that in dice we want to pick up a small part of the cube from the whole cube. Fine. So this is all about dice operation. Now the fourth operation is slice. Now you must be knowing what basically when we are using the word slice in terms of fruits or vegetables, like right, we are doing one slice of apple, one slice of mango, right? So slice, doing slice of fruits means what? We are simply cutting it from one side, like making slice like this or making slice vertically. Fine. That is what we mean by slice. So similar thing will happen here. Slice operation means what? This whole cube is there and I just want to take one upper slice from it. So it is known as slice. Like you can see here example. For example, this is the cube given to us. What we want is we simply want the first level slice of it. This I want to divide it from here. Fine. I want to divide it from here. So only this upper slice I want. So if I make the slice like this, what data I will have? I will have these four locations as it is: Chicago, New York, Delhi, Mumbai. And I will have these four items as it is: mobile, modem, PC and laptop. Fine. But obviously if I am breaking it like this, I am making a slice of it, I will not get the details of the quarters, but I will get these informations. Fine. So after doing slice operation on this cube, I will get something like this. Fine. So this is what slice operation is. And the last one is pivot. Now as the name itself indicates, pivot, you must know that what is pivot. Pivot means nothing but rotate. Just remember that pivot means rotate. So it is simple one. When any data like this is given and you are told that apply pivot on this. So pivot means what? You simply need to rotate it once. So after rotating it once, consider that CNDM that is here. Like CNDM is nothing but these locations, right? The initial of the locations. So after rotating it once, what I will get is CNDM will come here and MMPCL, it will come this side. Fine. So I am just rotating it once. These dimensions will come here and these dimensions will come here. So pivot is nothing but simply rotating any given data that is given to you. So the dimensions will change, nothing else. Fine. So and these were the main OLAP operations. We have seen them in detail. If you want, you can take a snapshot of this so that it can be helpful. You can make notes or it can be helpful to you in your exam. You can take the note of it. So I hope you have understood all the operations properly. If you like the video and if you found it helpful, please like it. Please share it with as many as people as possible. And if you have not subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe the channel. And if you have any doubt, you can always ask in the comment section. Thank you so much.